All right, we should be live. So in this stream, this one is, I don't even know if I'll keep this one up, but this stream is all about letting you know what I've been talking about behind the scenes for so long. Well, not so long, probably in the last, what, month? Chirac, what's up? My audio working? Well, not so long, it should be working. Giovanni's here, Gray Hayes is here. Did I say Giovanni? I'm going to say Diavani if I said Giovanni. Diavani's here. Leroy Jenkins. What's up? Aaron Strickling. Welcome, YouTube official. So I'm going to get straight to it. So one component. I'm just going to guide you through this world called CryptoVoxels. And the reason I'm showing you this is because, let me copy my coordinates so I don't lose where I'm at. The reason I'm showing you this is because I want to show you the potential of where we could take stuff. Now, this is only one portion of what we're working on. I don't want to make this seem like it's the only thing. Beatmaker and super producer. What's up, the Lob Mob? Beatmaker and super producer, or producer versus super producer? I think super producer means like somebody who's just unbeaten in the market, who has a streak, so to speak, in the market. So real quick, what I'm going to do is describe where we're at right now and show you why I'm looking for the top of the top producers. So if you want to submit to be on this kind of insider producer team, my email is beats4busy@gmail.com. And I'm looking for sound designers, top of the line producers, and good songwriters too. So we're looking for the combination. I have a pretty cool thing coming out. I don't want to give all the details away, but I want to show you this part because we just spoke with someone who owns property in CryptoVoxels, which is what's called the metaverse. So basically the metaverse is, it's free to submit to me if that's what you mean, produced by MDA. So what the metaverse is like playing Minecraft or like playing Fortnite, but in real. Oh wait, how'd you get here? Wait, who is this? Oh, I posted it in the chat. I was like, how did that freaked me out because I'm like, who even has the address? Okay, that threw me off for a second. Okay, so CryptoVoxels, basically, so imagine this is, so let me explain real quick what CryptoVoxels is. So the metaverse is basically the digital version of our world, and people are literally buying up virtual real estate, and they're like developing this virtual real estate. So think of Fortnite or Minecraft, but like monetized, like real businesses, real people, not just a video game. Yeah, that super producer. What is that noise? Oh. So basically you can join on your phone or PC or computer. Where we are, just to explain what the heck this is, because it probably looks like Minecraft to you guys. So what this is, again, we're in the what's called the metaverse, which is basically the virtual, digitized version of our world, basically. And yes, so another place is called Decentraland, which looks more like Fortnite. This one looks more like Minecraft. And so where we're at currently, for the people who are even here, is this is basically a virtual stage. So if you can imagine, all this stuff will be changed out with the theme of the artist, pictures on the thing, videos playing in the background, and you know, this stage will be looking like an actual, like, hip, whatever the artist is, it will look like that on the stage. Currently, right now, these are just placeholder images and placeholder textures and different things. So imagine this is all blacked out, for example, and then you got Kanye videos in the black with him and his like Doberman Pinscher and Jay-Z and their song, what's the throne song, or what's that album called with Kanye and Jay-Z? I forgot what it's called. Watch the Throne. So you got the Watch the Throne stuff in the background, then you got lights going off up top, like a virtual concert. And the cool part is that this virtual space, you got to think like real life right now, because the one thing we don't have in real life right now is we don't have the ability to tour right now. I think one lady who manages touring, she said there's 6 million jobs lost from touring. There's 6 million people out of work that used to get money from touring. And she said there's people calling her getting hysteric about saying that they can't tour and they don't have any money and all this type of stuff, and they're like super upset. So, you know, think about the virtual world. Like Ariana Grande did a concert on Fortnite. Travis Scott did a concert on Fortnite. So they, you can do the same exact thing, but in this place called CryptoVoxels, which is basically, they call it the Web 3.0. So we're moving from what's called Web 2.0 over to Web 3.0, which is like the new version of the internet, basically. And the main difference is that the new version of the internet, you can actually go through the internet as if it's a physical place. And that's the main difference about Web 3.0 characteristics versus Web 2.0. So imagine this new world where you can click on the actual wall and go to stuff like hyperlink. You could hyperlink across the map. You could hyperlink to another virtual piece of real estate. So for the people who are in this little stage area, you don't have to follow me. I'm just going to show the people on YouTube what we're doing. And I didn't know this had sounds, so I don't even know how to turn that off. But again, imagine people doing virtual concerts in here. Now, let me show you guys the downtown version. So this is kind of like the to be developed area. And again, it's like a concert hall type thing. And it's legit, like it's, whoa. So you hear that music? So you can walk into these virtual websites basically, and it has music behind it. So imagine partnering with these people who own the properties to get your music in their stores. I don't even know how to turn that off. How do I turn that off? Where's that music coming from? I have no idea. All right, let me mute it real quick because I don't know where it's coming from. I have no idea where that music just randomly came from. But so imagine people coming on here. Is my stream choppy? My bad. Hold on a sec. I think it's because I have video. Dang, is my stream choppy? Let's see. Let me know if the stream gets too choppy. Maybe. Here, I'll do one thing real quick. My fault. Let me turn that off. Yeah, so this is like, this is just one aspect of something that we're kind of working out. So this is only like one of the many, 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 many things. This is like a tiny piece, but I just wanted to show you guys what's happening to the world. Okay, so the world is basically undergoing a completely, it's the game. The game is choppy. Oh, you sure? Because my cam was like glitching around a little bit. So just let me know if it's me. So basically, okay, so in this virtual world, again, think of a website, but then think of a website that you can walk through and navigate through as if it's a real place. This is the Web 3.0 in what's called the metaverse. So people currently, if you've heard of NFTs, they're basically art-based pieces, and you can put up your art, your virtual art, and then put it in a real place. So this is where the other side of NFTs comes into play. Like I can display my art in a virtual house, for example. So instead of me buying the real Mona Lisa and putting it up in my real home and my real gallery, I can put it up in my virtual gallery. And the only way to be in the virtual gallery is to have virtual art. There's no other way to hang up on my virtual wall a real painting. So this is why NFT art is becoming so popular. People are learning about ways where they can start to actually utilize their artwork in the virtual space. And artwork is just the beginning. So if you guys heard, if I unmute this tab real quick, this gallery has music behind it. So I'm gonna mute it real quick because I don't know how to turn it off. But the gallery has music behind it. So think about how many virtual pieces of real estate have music behind them. And think about how many pieces of art. So another cool thing about NFT art is that you can pair them with music, just the same way we can do sync licensing with movies. You can pair your music with this specific picture up here. You can pair it with that picture, for example. So the owner, if they click on this picture and they open it up, they can experience the picture with the music. So it's a whole different way of thinking about the internet. Like I'm gonna kind of guide you guys through this virtual world, and think of it like a video game, because it really is like a video game. But think of it like a video game. Hold on, I had my hands on this before. But think of it like a video game that we can live in virtually. Now, the next level of the world, I put the link here. Let me put the link back in the chat. But the next level of the real world, I'm just kind of giving you guys the advancement of technology, is going to be where we put on special glasses. Facebook is working on them right now. They're glasses called, like, there's some special Ray-Bans that you can record video with. But I think they're prepping us to get ready for augmented reality glasses. So imagine putting on a pair of sunglasses. You walk outside. Everything is like bland or white or something like this. But then when you look at the walls, it'll have stuff moving around on the walls because your glasses are reading digital information. What's up? Your glasses are reading information off of the digital wall, and then you can customize your experience in the real world. So basically everything will, in the future, once we implement this augmented reality stuff, you'll be able to walk out in the real world with glasses on and experience all the buildings having custom whatever on it. And we're gonna reskin the world basically that with augmented reality. Imagine stuff popping out of the wall. Imagine going to Disneyland, you put on glasses and like stuff's, Disneyland has been doing this forever actually, and stuff's popping out of the walls and like animated stuff. So that's gonna be the next level. So let me quickly kind of take you through this world. So again, it's like a real life Minecraft. Like people pay real money to buy real property, to buy virtual property. And they can like customize it like a real house. So you have some stores which people sell their NFT artwork so that you can hang it up in your virtual house. You have stores that are just like, again, it's like a website. Like it's like going to a website. So I don't know who these people are, but they look happy. He looks happy. Whoever that is looks happy. But imagine you can do this on your computer and your phone. And that's the cool part about crypto voxels. The only other part about Decentraland is that you can't, from what I understand, play it on a phone. I think you have to have a computer that has a lot of power. But crypto voxels, look at this. It's like walking into a New York store. You're just digital. And again, the reason I'm showing you this is because I just met up due to Chris Moyer, my mentor, now business partner. He introduced me to a guy. I want to keep his name private for now because I don't know if he wants to be public about it. But a person who owns property in this specific world. And he said, yeah, like whatever we can dream up of as a community, that'll be fun for everybody. Let's try it on this new, one of his properties on here. So we get to basically dream up what we would like to do on one of his properties. And we could do concerts on there. We could do beat battles on here. We could do whatever. That's what I'm saying. I want to figure out ways to be cool about this new virtual world. So I'm just going to kind of go through and look at other people's concepts and ideas. So again, NFT artwork, you can put it on the walls. So again, if you've ever played Minecraft, you understand the value of this. So these are real artwork pieces that people sell for real money. If I click this, it's going to open up his NFT marketplace link. Let's see how much this costs. Okay, it costs 35 real dollars to buy this. And what you would do is you buy it now, and then it goes to your what's called a wallet. Basically, your wallet's like a hard drive. It just goes to your hard drive where it stores your item. And it also, without getting into the nitty-gritty about what an NFT does, basically, they can be collectibles. And only you can have it in this virtual world. It's lagging. Wait, let me see. Is the screen lagging or what's lagging to you? It looks fine on my screen. So let me know if anybody else is lagging, but it looks fine on my screen. So again, these are real. So again, the simplest way to understand this, it's Minecraft, but with real money and real property costs. Like it costs a lot of money to get property on this virtual place. And people are putting up stuff for sale. So let's click this. This looks pretty cool. I want that for my virtual house. Oh, you mean the game on your phone? Yeah, sometimes on the phone, it acts different. You probably have to go on a computer. But let's see how much this painting is. So that looks cool. I want to put it in my virtual house. Let's see how much that costs. If it loads up here. And the whole trick for us producers is to figure out ways to, I don't know why this link isn't opening up, but let's say it costs 500 bucks. I spent 500 real dollars to put that in my virtual house or my store, wherever I want to put it. But again, the cool part about this is that we can link up with all these shop owners. You hear this music? Okay, different music. we can... Let me see if I can turn the music off from where we are. I don't know why we're hearing music in the hallways part, but... Hold on, let's see. But I do know on this world, if you go to certain people's shops, it will play their music in their shop, like their custom-made music. So again, there's so much property on this. Let me see if I can make this map bigger. Look at how much virtual real estate there is. It looks like playing Grand Theft Auto as far as like the map size. Let's zoom out a little bit. So we're only in one little tiny portion of the map. Look how huge this map is. Okay, so look at all that virtual real estate, and you can partner up with all the virtual shop owners and the homeowners in this place and then put your music behind their NFT art and put it into their... this is like the new level of sync licensing and publishing. Okay, so this is what I've been... Oh yeah, do your thing. This is only for just showing you a little bit ahead of what's happening here. Why is my stream tripping? 0 KPS, okay, that's not good. I think the stream might be a little heavy on the resources or whatever on the computer. So I'll be quick about this. I just wanted to show you guys a piece of what's coming. No, this isn't a video game. This is, I'm trying to show you like the next level of what music will be. So you see this little play button right here? If I play this, see how the music changed too? So let's hit play. You can play videos, you can play music. So again, we're in a virtual world. So imagine your video playing on a wall as an advertisement while somebody walks into their virtual store, listening to your music over the virtual store. Okay, and then you can run video ads like you see in Times Square. Stream died, did it? It's choppy on my screen. I don't think it died though. Hold on, yeah, let me figure this out. Because I want to give you guys some game before I head out. It didn't die, what do you mean? I don't know, maybe some people are experiencing problems, some people aren't. I'm not gonna obsess about it, but I just wanted to show you this is the future of what is happening. And I want you guys to be able to make as much money as you can partnering up with these people, because there's a gazillion artists that need to partner up with music people to make this whole experience. Okay, so for example, the reason this room sounds so cool is because it has that tone, that music behind it. And look, if I go into a different room, it plays different music. There's even like echolocations where the music gets louder. So you see right here, this is where the music's coming from. Okay, then I can move into another section of the store where it doesn't play the music as loud. So this is literally where technology is heading. So imagine the actual world walking around as pedestrians, going to all these stores, looking at all this NFT art. This one looks super sick. Open that up. This one is, it's only 350 thou. Something light, you know, something light. Only $500,000 for this painting right here for your virtual house. Something light. Wait, did the stream end? Am I putting you guys on too much game? Where can you get more info? Well, you can start with the link there. That's where you can get more info. Oh, maybe the stream like flipped for a second. Dang, as soon as I try to show you guys something, I don't think my computer can handle the upload speed. What's up, Jelati? This would be perfect for DJ Wraith to partner up with people like this. Okay, so again, this guy is selling his painting, his virtual painting, for $250,000. Let's see how much the Joker painting is for. Oh, the Joker painting is only $342,000. You can put it in your virtual house, your virtual store. So this is, and now imagine you partner up with this artist that's selling his thing for $350,000 and your music is tied to it. Maybe you made some custom Joker style music behind it. Now you can work out a deal with him to where you get an automatic percentage of his sale. So now let's say you get 10% as a producer. 10% of 350,000 is 35,000. Would you rather chase placements for $2,000 a placement, or would you rather work with an NFT artist who does drops for $250,000, and you get 10% of that every single time. And on top of that, in this world, you get kickback royalties if it's put into what's called a smart contract. So for example, if he has it set up to where he sells this painting for $250,000 and he has what's called a smart contract set up, basically he gets royalties on the back end. So if it sells again for $400,000, he'll get 10% of that, and then you get, or he'll get whatever the percentage is for that, and then you'll get 10%, or whatever your percentage is, you'll get that, okay? So I want you guys to start thinking outside the box. These are the people you want to collab with. Look outside of just simple rap artists right now. This is the new world, and they need your help to make it vibrant. Like, this whole world is all tech-based, but the only thing they're missing is the life, the creativity to it. And so that's what I want to introduce you to. If you really want to be a super producer, you got to figure out how to get into this world. And this is what I want to introduce you guys to at some level, is how to get into this type of world. So we're going to be doing some stuff in CryptoVoxels soon to test it out and see what it's all about. So let's go to a different side of the world on here. I was like, what's that music? I guess it just plays music when you're in the hallways. It plays random music. So this person has a random car thing. Okay, so you can see how all these rich people, basically all these people are just super rich. And we can see how they think. So let me see if I can go to downtown on the map. I forget how to navigate on here. Let me mute this for a second. I was getting a little loud. Yeah, so hopefully you didn't miss my whole spiel, Loner Square, because I spit some bars. Hopefully nobody missed it. But I'm trying to take you guys to downtown, because if you see downtown, it'll all make a lot of sense. I got lost. Where's downtown at? Hold on, I got to pull up the map. How do I get over there? Hold on. Only thing I don't know how to do is free this cursor thing so I could get to the map. How do we do this? Also, these have real addresses. It's almost like a website. So every location that you have is like its own URL. The coordinates change. So if I move one step over here, the literal URL just changed. So every little like millistep is like a different URL or different website, so to speak. I can't pull up the map, so I don't know how to do the map thing, but let me see if I can find center of the map. Because if I show you guys the center of the map, so this is just like New York real estate. The closer to the downtown center you get, the higher the price. Because if you go to what's called CryptoVoxels.com, everybody loads into this generic kind of downtown. Yeah, it is a little laggy because I'm speeding through here. But look at this virtual sneakers that you can put on your avatar. So if I press, I think he said it was Q, or what's the button I gotta press? If I press C. Okay, so if I press C, I can look at my character in third person. So another cool person you want to link up with are the people who make the virtual assets. So they're releasing virtual sneakers. French Montana just released a sneaker and then a virtual sneaker that you can put on your character. Okay, so you want to figure out how to get into deals like that, because if you can figure out how to partner up with French Montana to get inside of a sneaker deal, it's just like sneakers in real life. People want to show off their sneakers in the virtual world. Like, I want these sneakers with the wings on them because I want to look fly that day for whatever reason. And you got to find those NFT artists. That's the key. And so that's what I want to introduce you to, is that side of things. Look at this. This is a stage right here. Now imagine them having a concert over here. Now you have 1,000 people crammed into this virtual space because people can't tour right now. So you have a virtual stage, you have thousands of people who don't feel like they're just looking at a YouTube feed. They're looking at a video game like thing. And they could look at it, have music playing. You could have an actual DJ. Look at this, DJ turntables, all types of stuff. This is literally a virtual festival. So I just wanted to keep you guys ahead of the curve. This is what this live stream is all about. How to get into the next level of music. So let's see if we can go to downtown, because if I go to downtown, it's really gonna make sense. So they have districts, so they have music district. They have, what was that friggin' Lionel Richie? They have the music district, they have art districts in here. Like segmented, here it is. We're getting closer to the center of the city. Okay, so you see the CryptoPunks put on display? These things are like a gazillion dollars. I don't even know if you could buy them. They're just put on display. So I don't think you can buy these. So somebody bought these and they just want to show how rich they are because they got money. So they just put them up in their virtual world and they could sell these again if they wanted to on one of the marketplaces. So that's what I'm saying. There's so much to this. Now this one I can buy. Let's see how much this is. This is 2.1 ETH. It doesn't say. I guess you have to make a bid on it. And I think ETH is worth like 400 per, I think. So it's like $800. Yeah, this would be the place that you want to link up with DJ Wraith. Cause this is, now you hear how it's just, I'm on mute right now. So the site looks, we're just looking at artwork, but once you unmute it, it opens up a whole new experience. It's kind of like when you play a video game on silent versus when you play with the sound on and your controller's vibrating. They have virtual cars. Come on. They have a virtual car dealership. Now imagine your music came on, and you got to remember, these people want to stay fresh. They're not going to have the same song on in the dealership every day. They're going to change it out. They literally built out a whole car dealership. All right, so this is downtown, I believe. And I want to show you guys one building before I move on to my next point. And I can't find it. Where the heck is it? But basically, a billionaire bought one of these properties, and I'm trying to find it. Where the heck is it? Basically, he built like a SpaceX building, and I'm trying to find it though. Where is it at? So legitimate people are in these spaces. This is not just for like video gamers. This is for like real people. Where is the property? I'm gonna feel so salty if I can't find the property. How much y'all think this one is? I'd say $500,000. Watch it be $500,000. Oh, it doesn't say. I'm assuming this is the price, 0.1 ETH, but I doubt that's the price because that's pretty fire. I know it looks weird right now, but we already play games like this and we're doing it for free. We're playing Minecraft for free. We're playing Fortnite for free. Now imagine a real world Minecraft, a real world Fortnite where you can actually spend real money. That's the trippy part about it. So I got lost. I can't remember where the SpaceX thing is. Oh, here's the Cybertruck. We're getting close. Okay, we found Cybertruck. Where the heck is the SpaceX building? But again, think about all the traffic that's gonna walk by in this world. You have people just walking around, they stumble across your festival. Now you have 10,000 new fans because people are just walking around. So that's the cool part about this. Now, where the heck is the SpaceX? I'm gonna try one more block. If I don't find it, then it is what it is. But believe you me, somebody spent money to build out like a SpaceX building, and it's like a skyscraper type building. And I can't find it. But yes, this is the new world. And I want to introduce you to all the people involved in this world. And I want to get you involved on some level with these good folks. So all that blank, empty stuff, I guess, is just real estate for sale. Dang, y'all, I really can't find it. Whatever, it is what it is. But yes, seems crazy, but we do. Look at this guy. He's fully kitted. He got his customizables. He has his face. That's why your character comes blank, because you're allowed to create your own character around the blank canvas. So this person designed their head or bought their head. They have like a purse thing on it. Okay. They have, it looks like clothes. I can't tell if that's clothes or if this is a black color. This is probably like a one of one head. So it probably costs a lot of money because it's one of one. And the purse probably one of one. Now imagine people walking around trying to have real status in your virtual world with your one of one purse. So what I wanted to do was come up with ideas for that space that I showed you. If you click that link, we're coming up with ideas for that space. So we could do like beat battles there. We could do 6ix9ine game. We could do beat battles there. We could do anything y'all could really think of. So I'm open to suggestions and stuff. But I think the cool part would be starting off with like a beat battle in that space that I showed you. And then we could sit there like we're in a real auditorium, like a real stadium. So yeah, there's so much to show you, but it's legit. There's so many people who bought property here. Crazy. And they all show off their artwork. So if you didn't understand what NFTs were, hopefully you understand why NFTs are important, because you could show it off in these worlds called the metaverse. So I won't belabor the point. I've already probably spent an hour on the point. And it looks like the stream blew up. So we are going to wrap this up. The stream blew up. All right, stream blew up. So I'm going to wrap this, but thank you all for hopping in with me. I just wanted to keep you updated. Peace.